hope you find here an incredible collection of good ideas. Plus inspiration.
What up, masters? Welcome to another special. I mean, this is really a special episode of... It's just actually a little clip with Mr. Jim Rohn, and I wanted to bring this to you. I don't know if I shared this before, but about 15 years ago, somebody gave me a Jim Rohn CD back when he was a sales trainer. There's one that's circulating everywhere if you listen to it. It's like a 45-minute Jim Rohn CD. It's amazing. But anyway, that was my first time being introduced to Jim Rohn, and it really had a huge impact on me. Like, just... it was the perfect thing to be introduced to me at the perfect time. Like I said, just a massive, massive impact. And then I kind of got away from it for a little while. And then about 11 years ago, I met Jairek Robbins, who's Tony's son, Tony Robbins. And I didn't know this. You may have, but I didn't. Is that when Tony Robbins got started, what he used to do was he used to go out and used to sell events for Jim Rohn. So he was kind of like the guy that went around and selling the Jim Rohn events. And that's how he got introduced into that industry of, you know, personal development and all that. Isn't that cool? That's such a cool story. But anyway, the Robbins family and the Rohn families are very, very close. So Jairek, who I met, I'm getting back to Jairek, it gave me this CD. Like I said, probably about 11 or 12 years ago, he did an event with us in Boston. And basically, it's a mixtape with Jim Rohn lyrics. It's awesome. So I just wanted to share a couple of those with you right now. And this is one of my favorites, and it's called Idea. So I hope you enjoy. And hey, I'd love to see you on our meetup. So it's every second Thursday of the month at 4 p.m. Just go to davidsmeetup.com. That's it. Love to see you. davidsmeetup.com. Every second Thursday of the month, 4 p.m. Eastern. All I got to do is go to the website, sign up for the next one, and hey, want to see you there. And I really appreciate you listening to the podcast, and I hope you enjoy this special, short Jim Rohn Ideas.
Turn nothing into something. And just make a note, link those two words together, ideas plus inspiration. Ideas. See, that can be the explosive start of something incredible. Ideas. Plus inspiration. Building of a company, the building of a country, the building of an idea, the building of an enterprise, the building of a relationship. Ideas plus inspiration. Ideas. Inspiration. Ideas powerful enough to finally become reality, and inspiration enough to make sure it happens. Ideas. Plus inspiration. You know, it's interesting. I've been doing a subject recently. Here's the title of it. How to Turn Nothing into Something. Ideas. Plus inspiration. How to Turn Nothing into Something. Turn nothing into something. You start with ideas and imagination. Now, it's hard to call ideas and imagination nothing. Turn nothing into something. How tangible are ideas and imagination? It's a bit of a mystery. So you can't really call ideas that can be turned into a hotel, ideas that can be turned into an enterprise, ideas that can be turned into the Salk vaccine, ideas that can be turned into miracle products, ideas. You couldn't really call the idea nothing.
Turn nothing into something.
It must have some kind of substance. And imagination can't really be nothing. We call it nothing because it isn't like tangible. It isn't like a podium. It isn't that real. But it is almost real. So to turn nothing into something, you start with ideas and imagination.
Turn nothing into something.
Interesting. Ideas that become so powerful in your mind and your consciousness, they seem real to you even before they become tangible. Imagination that is so strong that you can actually see it. You can actually see it. Ideas.
Plus inspiration. Turn nothing into something.
Imagination. Ideas. plus inspiration. Imagination. Here's what I say, and this is good philosophy. It seems like opposites are in conflict and we are in the middle. Evil on one side, good on the other side. Illness on one side, good health on the other side. Darkness on one side, light on the other side. And they're in conflict. They're in conflict. If you walk into a room that's dark and turn on the light, the darkness disappears and goes away. How far away does it go? Not very far. Waiting for a chance, what? Come back in. Move in, take over the territory. They're in conflict. As light begins to lose its energy, darkness moves in. There's a war on. Here's what it's called. Push. They're in conflict. As we sit here, right? Good health plan is trying to defeat illness and drive it into a small corner. If you don't work on your good health plan, illness will drive your health into a small corner. It's called push and shove. They're in conflict. In your bloodstream, there are red corpuscles to nourish like a mother and white corpuscles to fight and kill like a father. They're in conflict. Thank God for white corpuscles that think negative all day. White corpuscles say, just show me some infection, I'll kill it. Because if I don't kill it, what? It kills you. They're in conflict. White corpuscles say, it's my job today to make sure you don't get killed. So I'm here to fight. Have you got that now? Red to nourish, white to fight. They're in conflict. Just show me some infection, I'll kill it. They're in conflict. So here's the key now. Cooperate with the positive side of this war of health and illness.
They're in conflict. They're in conflict.
What if in this struggle the body calls for a banana and you send it a Coca-Cola?
They're in conflict.
And now the body has the right to say what? Whose side are you on? I'm working day and night to drive illness into a small corner and keep you healthy, and you keep sending me the wrong stuff.
They're in conflict.
Come on, just a little cooperation here, and we can win this game.
They're in conflict.
But see, if you don't do your push-ups, and what was that little voice in my hotel room this morning that said to me, Jim Rohn, you don't have to do your exercises this morning. You're running a little late, and this little creature on this shoulder almost talked me into it.
They're in conflict.
And the little angel says what? No, 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 no. Fall on the floor one more time. Do those push-ups, a few crunches, a little modified version, yes, because you are late, but you got to keep up the pace. See, that's called what? The work of summer.
They're in conflict.
We can win this game. Because it's also possible to love like a father and hate like a mother, just so you get the job done. And if it's a single parent, right, you got to do both the work of father and mother. Extraordinary. We can win this game.
They're in conflict.
We can win this game.